So at this time, we want to dismiss our children to go with our children's director, Kirsten Alamos, to their chapel time. And I'm going to invite forward Jane Reicher. She's already forward. To come and share with us. I need a microphone. There we go. Thanks, Sean. You're about to embark on something exciting, aren't you? Tell us a little bit about it.
I'm getting ready to go to the Dominican Republic for the sixth time. And she's working as a nurse. This time I'm going to be the only person doing missionary. There are several people that are going for a social reason, and I wasn't planning to go this time. And the pastor down there emailed me and said, "Are you coming?" And I said, "No, not this time." And he said, "Oh, I was hoping you would do home visits and work with our health aides that you've been teaching." And so God tugged at my heart, and I thought about it, and it's all worked out. And partly it's worked out because of this congregation being generous and helping with some support money that's going to help me go.
So through the missions team here, you are kind of being sent as one of our emissaries to go and do this work. And so what happens when you go into these homes and do these visits?
It's almost like working in the emergency room. You get up in the morning and you have no idea what you're going to see. So
it sounds like a church.
So I start off the morning with a backpack that's about 40 pounds because I kind of try to be prepared for anything. I see patients in their homes with hypertension, with diabetes, people who need referrals to hospitals. Sometimes we end up getting somebody to a hospital. Lots of wound care, machete wounds. That's a lot of what I'm doing. That's a lot of teaching.
Yeah, so you're training the people that are down there as well.
I'm teaching, yes. I'm working with a group of young women who then go into the homes and try to follow up and they take blood pressures and do blood sugar checks and do wound care when I'm not there.
Wow.
And actually, part of the area is now they don't need me. They have people that are established enough in two of the barrios that I was visiting 6 years ago that they don't need me anymore, which is awesome.
That's outstanding. So the Great Physician calls us to heal one another, to carry one another's burdens, to watch over them, and you are tangibly doing that down in the Dominican Republic. How exciting is that? So let's have a prayer for Jane as she gets ready to go on Wednesday. How long are you going to be there? For a week. Okay, so if you want, put a hand out this way towards the front, and I'll put a hand on Jane, and we will bless you on your way.
Specific prayer.
Sure. Yes. Yes.
Safe travel, good health, and that everybody there recognizes that I'm the hands and feet of Jesus doing what I do.
That sounds. Those are perfect. Lord, thank you for Jane. Thank you for her willing heart. That when that pastor reached out and said, "We need you," even though she had other plans, other things she was doing, she heard God's voice, she heard your voice, you whispered to her, said, "Go," and she went. She's going. Thank you so much for opening the doors, for sending her down. We pray for safe travel, that you would speed her on her way down to the Dominican Republic. We ask that you would just go before her, that healing would be in her hands, that as she would share and teach and care, that your spirit and your presence would be upon her. We pray that the good news of your gospel and the love that you have for all people would flow from her and through her to all of these people, letting them know that you are walking with them, and that Jane is those hands and feet of you, our Lord, that are those tangible presence for her. We ask that you would bless her, that you would watch over her, and that her ministry and her work would continue to increase so that the blessing would travel even beyond the week that she spends there. Bless Jane. Watch over her and bring her back to us. In Jesus' name, amen.